Yeah, I did some shopping a while back. So this is FPGBC. If you don't know, this is essentially a Game Boy clone. It's made by a company that makes a lot of the replacement parts for Game Boy Color. Now, why would you want such a thing? First of all, price. This is surprisingly affordable. Even compared to an unmodded Game Boy Color, it's very competitive. And compared to a modded one, oh, this is significantly cheaper than any other alternative. A competitor to this product will be something like Analog Pocket or a Game Boy Color with an IPS screen mod. And this is far, far cheaper. Now, the only problem with this kit is that you have to install it yourself, but I think that it's not really gonna be that difficult. So I wanna show you that even for a beginner like myself, that I can pull this off. So let's begin. So what you need to order from Funny Playing Games is you need to order the FPGBC itself. So this is the FPGBC. So it comes with the screen, the board, the speaker, and the battery. So you will need to order a case, a button membrane, and buttons. These are absolutely essential. If you have spare buttons, you don't have to order them, but because it uses a specially modified case that fits the FPGBC, you will need to buy these separately. You could theoretically cut the shell yourself and then install it, but if you don't want to go through that hassle, just get one from Funny Playing Games. Now, because this is not a tutorial on how to install this kit, because I'm an amateur, I'm not gonna be very good at instructions. So it's just gonna be sort of a demonstration that even a noob like me can do it, so anyone can do it. Now, very important note, before assembling it, please check if everything works, because there have been instances on Reddit where people bought this kit and then after installing it, they noticed like a small green thing appearing on their screen, and then later on as they used it, it kind of ruined the screen completely. But Funny Playing wouldn't accept a refund or replacement because you've already installed it. So it is highly recommended that you test the kit out before putting it all together. I'll leave a link down to the guide that I'm following. It's from K's Retro Gaming. The problem with the instruction that I'm watching is that it is not showing us how to test the thing before installing it, which is an issue. Lucky for me, I have an iFixit kit. Now you're gonna need two different types of drivers, which is Philips 00, which is your regular sort of plus shaped one. And you need something called a Y00. If you've ever done a GBA, it is the identical type. It screws out. Got another cover, which I don't need. Now, obviously, if you have some tweezers, a plastic tweezer, this is gonna be a breeze through the park. Unfortunately, I don't have any plastic tweezers. So I'm gonna have to do it with hands. But even with hands, it shouldn't be too difficult. Just line it up, you know, line up the cable and
oh my God, is it in? Tell me it's in.
It's sort of in. Now the really finicky bit. I'm gonna have to install the battery. Now the battery installation is easy. It's gonna look really janky, but trust me, the guide doesn't actually tell you to test it, but you need to test it. I'm having issue with connecting the battery. It's not connecting. There's a, even in the guide, there's this, do you notice how the middle bit is sticking out a bit more than the other sides? The connector is not shaped like that. So I think this was a manufacturing issue, quality control issue. So right now I figured out, I finally managed to connect the battery. You just have to shove it in. What I'm gonna do is I check the screen and the screen does work. However, I wanna see if it can run a game. And what better than Super Mario Land? Ooh, it's a bit tight. Okay, careful with the screen. Very careful with the screen. Cause yikes. Turn it on. FPGBC. Ooh, wow, immediately, okay. Hang on. That doesn't sound right. I have in my possession the original unmodified Game Boy. I don't know why, but this speaker just sounds a bit muffled to me. So I wanna, oh, that's really stiff. So I want to test it out on the original. Let me just max the volume. Okay. Okay. No, it sounds fine. I thought it just sounded a bit sort of muffled or dull. Turns out the original Game Boy is also kind of muffled and dull. So I think we're good. And pop it in and apply pressure on the sides. Voila. Voila. Now undo the film and you are good to go. Ta-da. Oh man. I don't know how long that took, but that was daunting, not gonna lie. It's not difficult. Here's the thing. If every single component was built properly, you wouldn't have any single issue. But like the case with the battery connector thing, that caused a bit of an issue, the way sort of the screen installs to the connector. But still, it's a nice hardware. No real issue whatsoever. There's a bit of a misalignment that I'm seeing. There's a bit of a build quality issue that I can see. Not due to the board, but the case itself. There's quite a bit of gap actually that I cannot find in the original. Interesting. It's not a huge deal, but kind of bothers me a little. So this is FPGBC. It is currently in the 4x mode, meaning it's scaling pixel perfect. However, you might be able to tell not all of the screen is actually being utilized, as you can see with the border here. So what you have to do is press this button in. When you press it in, you get this menu. Now, this has been criticized for a couple reasons. One is that it actually does let you change the speed of your Game Boy. Problem is, it doesn't tell you which speed is the default. So if you've never grown up with Game Boy, or if you're not like 100% familiar with the hardware, you will never know what the actual speed is supposed to be like. So do not touch that. However, if you want to utilize all of your screen, change the display mode from 4x to 4xp. This is the pixel mode and full. Now, is this good? Honestly, on my screen, this doesn't look bad at all. Like, I wouldn't mind, honestly wouldn't mind playing it like this. It looks completely fine to me. Yeah, this looks great. And it does have full compatibility with a lot of games, including, oh, that's rough. Including our dear old friend, Everdrive. Let's test this out. Now it's launching in full screen mode, which is nice. It's hanging a bit. Are you serious? It's not gonna work. What the hell? What the hell? I thought it was gonna work. What? Okay, that's... Come on. Don't let me down. Don't let me down. You're supposed to work. Come on. What are you doing? Okay, this is not good. So, when this came out, there were reports saying that it wasn't working with Everdrive. And I'm fairly certain I saw a post saying that they fixed it. Looks like they didn't fix it enough. It's not working. I mean, it's not really a huge deal, because they can always update the firmware and continue working on it. So I'm not too worried about it. But at the same time, man, that's pretty rough. Let's try another game. Pokemon Yellow. See if that works and see how that looks. Looks gorgeous. The speaker, let me bump it up. Very nice. I don't hear any static. It's just excellent. Is this a perfect Game Boy? I think to a lot of people, this is an excellent option. There's certain things about this product that might not satisfy you 100%. What do I mean by that? So this is the original Game Boy Color, Atomic Purple. This is FPGBC. Notice anything different? So the screen is larger on this device and is missing the Game Boy Color logo. Now that might not be a huge deal to some of you, right? So the screen's different, there's no logo. The side, this is a wheel, this is a volume wheel, whereas this is a volume toggle. Let's see if you can pick that up. It is not a wheel at all, it's a toggle thing. So you flick it like so. And the weird thing is, on a Game Boy Color, original Game Boy Color, if you want to increase the volume, you scroll downwards. This is the loudest, and this is the lowest. On a FPGBC, it's the opposite. If you want to increase the volume, you flick it upwards. If you want to decrease the volume, you flick it downwards. Because modern devices, usually if you want to increase the volume, you flick it up or scroll up. If you want to decrease the volume, you sort of scroll or flick down. A lot of people, it'll make way more sense. But if you're a stickler, this will be a better option. Now, another sort of thing that you might not have ever thought of is that this is heavier, but it's balanced. What do I mean by that? So the original Game Boy, it's very light device if you take the batteries out. But once you put the batteries in, it becomes a bottom heavy device. Because if you think about it, I mean, the battery is located in the bottom, and the screen is a plastic lens, so there's no real weight on top of it. Whereas the FPGBC is a laminated screen, right? So when you're holding it, and if you're used to the original Game Boy Color, you might feel that it's a bit top heavy. When in fact, it's actually a balanced device. It's actually perfectly balanced. So that's something that you should probably consider. It's not a huge deal. I mean, it's not really a deal breaker, but if you're like really used to the original Game Boy, this might be, you might have some difficulty getting used to this product. But at the same time, if you were planning to get a original Game Boy Color with an IPS screen modded, you're gonna be having the same issues anyway. So it's really a matter of IPS versus the original screen, right? It's something that you're gonna have to get used to if you wanna have a nice screen. Which one should you buy? Personally speaking, just get either, right? Just get whatever makes sense to you. In my opinion, I think you should just get the original. Not because this is a bad device or whatever, but I think I've actually changed my mind a couple times with this. So when I first looked at this screen, I was appalled by it. I hated it so much. Because I went from Game Boy SP to this. And so this was a huge downgrade and I just couldn't stand it. I didn't get why there was this red light blinking. Nothing about it made sense to me. But the more I had it, the more I used it, I sort of realized that, oh, this is something special. And if you're buying Game Boy nowadays, there's a very good chance you're not really buying to have the best experience. You're buying it to have the most authentic experience, the most nostalgic experience, the experience that you never got to have as a kid. And so in that sense, I do recommend the original. However, just using this device as is, you're gonna be having some difficulties, especially in scenarios where you don't have enough light that's shining on the screen. So in that sense, I do recommend getting one of these devices as a secondary device. I actually recommend getting both because this will offer the most authentic, original sort of nostalgia. And this one will be sort of a nice side device to have for days that you just want to experience it in a more refined, modern, bright display than this. Do I recommend this over the original? If you don't care about authenticity, Sure, go for it. How about the competitors? How about like Analog Pocket or Game Boy Color with an IPS modded screen? Truth be told, they're too expensive. They're way too expensive. Like, let's be real here. Analog Pocket is like, what, how much? Like $200, $300. A Game Boy Color with an IPS screen mod is roughly in a sort of similar price category. Me personally, I can't justify that price. Analog Pocket can do more. It can do a lot more. And Game Boy Color with an IPS screen mod will give you the authentic sort of Game Boy experience with the new screen. However, you cannot deny the value proposition this device brings to the table. It is absolutely fantastic, and I highly, highly recommend it. So in conclusion, if you have an original Game Boy Color and you want a sort of a newer device that will, you know, provide a better, slightly better experience, it was pretty easy to install. There were a couple issues here and there, but considering everything, like the price and how easy it is to obtain it. However, if you are completely new to the Game Boy scene, like myself, and you want to experience what it was like back then, I highly recommend you get both and see, you know, see if it's any good. Even this, this is gonna be pretty rough on you initially, but it will definitely grow on you. This device has definitely grown on me over the days, and I honestly enjoy it. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.